Here's a softball.
If we have to offset
the extended
unemployment benefits, it so happens that the cost of the carried interest loophole for hedge fund managers and private equity managers each year, that loophole costs, and nobody thinks it's it's justifiable. I mean, they are not using their making their own investments; they're getting capital gains treatment. The cost of that loophole is almost exactly per year the cost of extending unemployment benefits. Why don't we just close that loophole and make sure that the people who need the unemployment benefits?
How long would we do it for? 100 weeks?
Well, we at
300 weeks?
At the very least, we would do it until the unemployment rate comes down to about 5.5 or 5.8%.
Which is traditional. And so, Governor, are you going to answer that?
Well, look, there's a lot of different ways you could pay for it. My group, by the way, that I'm involved with now does not include hedge funds. So
you're supportive. You and I agree on another thing tonight.
But look, you said it's $6 billion gross over 3 months, and if you net out the positive effects on the economy, it might be $2 or $3 billion. That's not unsolvable. I mean, reasonable people, you and I could sit down in an hour probably in the back room of the Capitol and figure that
out. Why don't we do that?
Well, you and I don't have
the people up there and just get this done.
But be fair, Speaker Boehner said he's not saying no, he's just saying pay for it. It shouldn't be that hard.
But you, wait a minute. There are two issues here. We already talked about why we.
Secretary, here's the real reason.
Since 1970, we haven't. But if we do have to pay for it, I'm serious. Why don't we get rid of some of those tax loopholes that benefit the rich?
And I think make sure that people who are hard up get the help they need. I think many Republicans, including the Chamber of Commerce and us, have said directionally and conceptually, look, if you want to lower rates and shrink exemptions, preferences, and otherwise to make it, you know, a net non-revenue raise, but have that be directionally the tax code reform, which is drop rates, get rid of exemptions, preferences, and deductions,
that money to pay for what people need in terms of extended unemployment benefits and a lot of other things like food stamps that are being cut. Why should the rich have all of not only a low marginal tax rate, but also all of these tax loopholes that have no economic justification whatsoever?
Well, Secretary, we've got to focus on what we can do. So if you want to talk about what we can get done, Republicans aren't going to raise taxes, and Democrats aren't going to, in the near term, cut entitlements. So those are interesting debates. I could sit here and say, well, why don't we help fix our finances and get the economy in a better spot by
dealing with our
runaway health care costs?
Getting rid of the carried interest loophole for big hedge fund managers? That is raising taxes?
But again, that's interesting, but if you want to get something done, these are people who are unemployed right now. The clock is ticking down to zero.
And if
somebody says to you, we're not doing that, you got to focus on the art of the possible.
72,000 a week are being added to the 1.3 million.
I want to take us in a slightly different direction. Governor, there is a reason why there is an agreement on what the pay for is, because some are using it for ideological and political purposes. And Congress as a whole, we'll concede this, has trust problems with the American people, but particularly Republicans in Congress, with their own party even, have trust problems. There's a new poll out today. 51% of Republicans disapprove of the Republican Congress. Explain this to me. These are self-inflicted wounds. They can't even get the easy stuff done. Tell me why their approval rating in their own party is so low.
Sure. You know, there is a bit of not a civil war, but at least a split in the Republican Party taking place. So if you look at the Congress, you've got people further to the right saying they're not conservative enough. And you've got traditional or establishment or moderate Republicans saying they're too conservative and too unpragmatic. So they're getting shot at from both directions. So that reflects that number. And it's a reflection of, I think, a bad reputation or bad impression of the Congress overall.
So how are they going to resolve it? How are they going to resolve this civil war that they're having? You represent one piece of it.
Yeah, you earn support. So you got to get stuff done.
You got to
be
stuff
trusted.
Done.
And so you don't just say, trust me and support me. You got to go earn it. So what do most people care about in this country? They want to have a job, a good paying job. They want to make sure their families are safe and their kids are safe. They want to put their kids in good schools. They want to be able to pay for college, pay for health care. If they got a little money left over, they might want to go walleye fishing in northern Minnesota.
Yes.
That's the bread and butter stuff. And all the rest of this crap about, they just want to know, are you really focused on my meat and potato, bread and butter issues? And if not, shut up.
I want to get to the energy question.
Can I just ask one quick question of the governor? But to reach that level of yes. So the American people believe that Republicans in Congress understand what they're going through and has an agenda to address it.
Yeah.
Don't you think that Republicans need an agenda?
Well, they have an agenda. You know, it just
that addresses the needs of reducing costs of college,
look, for most,
putting people back
most
to
people
work.
In this country, their pathway to a good life is whether they have a good job. Now, the secretary has an agenda on how he thinks that should be done. I think it's fair to say Republicans have an agenda. You know,